Hey everybody, thanks for being here. This week, we're on Riffe Lake for some old-fashioned trout fishing with Uncle Jerry and John Kaiser from Salt Patrol. If you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. This morning, we're on Riffe Lake for some old-fashioned trout fishing with Uncle Jerry and John Kaiser.
We're at Riffe Lake. It's May. We're going to try for triploids and maybe some coho. They got coho in here, and they have rainbows, so it's a little bit of an assortment. As you can see, the lake's down quite a bit. They've drawn it down, so the dock's not even in the water, so we're going to try and sneak in through the backside here and give it go down, start trolling some downriggers and maybe one back rod, see how it goes. But typically nice fish come out of here. You know, this is part of the Cowlitz River, you know, reservoir up above here, you know, so it's typically a pretty good fishery in the springtime, so we'll see what happens.
If I'm the one that has to go get the truck at the end, you're gonna have to give me about a half an hour to walk up the ramp.
I think we're just gonna go out here and start trolling down the lake. That's kind of what we've done before, and it seemed like it worked out well for us. So. There's fish all the way through here. I mean, they're all over the place. We've caught just about everywhere. So, but caught more coho probably down past the island as you go down here. But you know, it just depends. You never know. Every day is different. You know, and this is not our regular fishery, so we typically would be chasing salmon. But you know, you got to find things to do. So. So we got a spinfish. We're going to put on this one here. And normally you break them apart, put your sand in them. But since we're running corn on the hooks, I'm just going to run it this way. And it works pretty good. We've caught just over Rufus Woods catching triploid on them there and kokanee. So I figured this would be a good shot. So this is some Procure. Made it up yesterday. Got a little shrimp in it. A little red color. And then Jerry's going to run the plane on that side and see what happens. Give them a little treat here. And we'll get the downriggers out. See what happens.
I'm using a small hoochie and some corn. Then I'm gonna put it on the downrigger and we're gonna go down. How deep are you gonna go with that one, John?
I don't know, maybe 15.
15, okay, I'll go down 23 or so. And we'll see where they are.
I'm going back about 50 feet, so this water in here is really clear, so it's kind of nice to get it away from the boat. There we go.
And
all we got here is basically a Scotty trout release. Pinch style. Works good for this. I'm gonna go down about 20 feet, or 15, maybe 15. Let's try it there. Try it shallow first. We got a pretty good shallow here last time.
I'm going about 40, just over 40.
So we're gonna run a dropper out the back, a little weight on it, set it down there. So this one's got a kokanee killer on it, and same kind of deal. And you can see we got a setup, put a weight right here. We're just going to run that back with a little light weight on it, get it just down a little bit. See what happens. It's caught fish out here too. Same deal. Got to put a little bait on it. Sorry. Okay. the one on the back. Okay, so this setup basically spinning rod. We got some, I think this is 15 pound Power Pro. Come down to a slider, a couple swivel, you know, in between there. So that's gonna take it down. And then I got a swing blade and back to a kokanee killer with some bait on it. So we're just gonna drop that out the back here, see what it does. And the dropper gets hit first. Alrighty, feels good. Bring it right in.
We're in southwest Washington on Riffe Lake, an impoundment of the Cowlitz River that's well known for its variety of fish species, including landlocked coho and king salmon, rainbows, triploided rainbows, and even planted hatchery steelhead. Riffe typically produces a mixed bag for anglers, and most of the time you won't even know what you've hooked until it's in the net.
Got a little silver.
But all of the species are good eating.
That's where the fish is at.
And fun to catch.
I'm down with a downrigger, down quite a bit deeper than that. We'll see if we get anything more up on top and then bring the other lines up.
In this cove here. So.
Bring them up to where the fish are.
But I've seen some in front of us here on the other one, so. We got a active target on the front, so I'm actually on the trolling motor. That's what all that wire is up there. You can see down here, it's actually scanning up to the front there. There's nothing on it right now. But this one's actually facing down right now. You can see where it's active here. So it's actually in the front of the boat, but it's aiming kind of this way towards the front of the boat. And then as you see fish, they'll come inside this. So this is basically looking to the front and then down. So we're looking down about 80 feet, but on the top here, I'm actually gonna set the range back up a little bit. But it, as it starts coming, down there, let me see if I can change this to like 40 feet. Okay, so now we're down. We're just looking at the top 40 feet of water. As they come in here, you actually see the fish swim into the pattern, so I can see them out in front of us before we get to them a little bit. So we've been trolling. We got one kind of trolling through this little inlet right here, and then I think I'm gonna head out towards the middle and go back and zigzag back and forth across like we did last time we fished with you. We caught quite a few of the bigger fish out there, so they were kind of traveling little schools. You'd mark them on a fish finder, and so we'll see what happens. Give it a shot, because I'm not seeing much along the beach here. And then the beach, we're talking beach, it's 156 feet deep here. So, I mean, this is a deep reservoir. I'm not marking any fish yet, so usually we'd see those pods, schools of fish, you know. When they lower the river, I mean, you know, when they drop the reservoir down, depends on where they move around to, you know, so it's hard to say. And we haven't been, this is the first time we've been down here this year too, so not to make any excuses. It's Jerry's fault, you know. He should. Obviously, he did not do it something right.
A little shallower here.
We changed from the spinner blade to a smiley blade that spins. Probably reflects a little bit more light, makes it brighter in these bright days.
Okay, we got one here. We're 229 now, but what we did is we came, it's only 50 feet over there by that point. We're coming across here, just kind of net going back and forth. And we moved down quite a bit, which might make a difference. So it was out there a ways. I had to let these other ones out a little farther. Yeah. Same as the other one, huh? Yeah, another little silver. Good eating, huh? So that was back. We had that back quite a ways. So So we're going to, I think we're going to do is go ahead and set the downriggers back, get them back farther. These are only 50 feet, and I had this probably 100 feet behind the boat. So maybe they just clear water. They want it back farther. So we'll give that a try next and go from there and see what happens. If you look at the way the dynamics are here, the way the beach is set up, we're at 50 feet of water all the way out here. We were at 150 feet a minute ago, but I'm thinking about putting a planer board out and running it along the shallows here so we can run it, let it out, and we can have it run right in, you know, a few feet of water with a little flatfish on it. See if we can pick up a triploid or something. So we got a little Yakima bait flatfish here. We're gonna send it up, see how it does. Nice gold color in the sun like today. Be pretty nice.
How far you want me to go out with this?
Right up by the beach.
Fish on.
Run. How deep were you?
19.
So, to mark something there, Jerry hooked up.
Smiley blade.
Who told you to put that on?
Justin says, guys, you're doing it wrong. You need a smiley blade on there.
Well, apparently that's what it took.
That's a bigger one.
Oh yeah.
That one's got a little color to it. There's your triploid.
Welcome back to Riffe Reservoir. I'm Justin Wolf. John Kaiser and Uncle Jerry started off slow, but after making a few adjustments, they're starting to put some quality fish in the boat.
A good one.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
This is what that fish hit on, and we got a sling blade, purple hoochie with a smiley blade on it. Single hook, fishing 90 feet behind the boat.
Did you have plain corn or green corn?
I had plain corn.
Plain corn, okay. The tuna corn.
Yeah.
Yeah, perfect. Come on back a little bit if you can. I gotta get the net.
There you go.
Jerry's making up for it now.
I was only back about 20 feet.
Good job, Jerry.
Right on.
All right.
They're biting now.
So I was running shrimp on mine, and on the one that Jerry was running, we had bloody tuna mixed in with the corn that I mixed up last night. So maybe, you know, go figure here in the lake. Bloody tuna, man, it works everywhere. So we're going to give that. We're going to switch over corn because Jerry just pulled two fish immediately. So we can't let him get too far ahead of us. So we're going to. Little silver horde. It's like a micro hoochie. Let's see what if that does anything. Put it behind the same blade because we know these work pretty good. No, we haven't had a strike since Jerry hooked those two. And I think we're going to run back up, go up that dam on the top end here, and maybe they're in that bowl up in there. I mean, I think we'd hammer out fish if we stayed here, but, you know, when we come here, we kind of expect to see more schools of fish, and then you kind of stay on them, and not really seeing that today. So it could be because of a bunch of water's moving through here. They're definitely drawing this down.
Hey, I hope you're enjoying this week's episode from Riffe Lake, where we're doing a little bit of trout fishing. Now, we all know that a small change can often make a big difference in the bite. And a small change made today by John Kaiser and Uncle Jerry was switching from a regular spinner to a smile blade. Now, one thing you can do with smile blades is tune them. You can bend them at a more severe angle like that, which means they will spin faster, or you can flatten them out, which means they'll spin slower. So you can just bend them however you want. And that really can be a way to dial in exactly what the fish want on that particular day. Now I'm gonna let you in on a little secret on another way to tune these that might even get you more bites. So what you're gonna do is take a pair of scissors and a smile blade, and we're gonna modify this by trimming off a little bit off of just one side, just like that. There. So now one side's a little bit smaller than the other. Now what that's going to do is make the smile blade kind of not want to wobble right. It's going to make it act like a wounded bait fish, and that's a big key. A predatory fish would much rather go after a wounded fish than a lively, active, healthy fish. A lot easier to catch a wounded bait fish than a healthy one. So this is going to mimic a wounded bait fish. It's going to have an off-kilter wobble and put out a different type of vibration. So that's a really effective way to use smile blades at times. Now the color that these guys chose to switch to was the UV glow burst, which is a great one. Lots of flash, obviously in the smaller size. Now storing all the different colors and sizes of smile blades has always been a little bit of a challenge. Keep them organized and available. So this was my box of smile blades that I've had for a long time, and you know, it works to do it like this, but boy, is there something better now. This is the fishing blade box. Now check this out. They won't fall out. So I've just started to put a few in here. I can organize all the different colors and sizes. I've just got them set in. They pull out just like that, and you're ready to go. These blade boxes are really cool, and they're new from Fishing. Now, what we're gonna do now is take a little break, and when we come back, we're gonna show you something really cool in Riffe Lake. Now, in a lot of the lakes around Southwest Washington, the hatcheries will take the excess steelhead and put them in the ponds. They just put some hatchery steelhead out here in Horseshoe Lake, which is right behind the store here in Woodland, Washington. Now, we had no idea that they were doing this in Riffe Lake, but we ended up catching one of these steelhead. And when we come back, we're gonna show you this fish. Now, don't laugh, it might be a little bit of an ugly fish, but I tell you what, it cut bright red and was great eating. So, really a fun day on the lake. So when we come back, we're gonna catch some more fish on Riffe Lake, including a big old steelhead.
Hooked up on the flatfish here. Little gold Yakima bait flatfish, trolling it right on the surface.
Welcome back to Riffe Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. On a back rod, John Kaiser has been trolling a small gold flatfish near the surface. And he's about to find out that Fish and Game releases excess hatchery steelhead into Riffe to give anglers a shot at them, while at the same time keeping them separate from the wild steelhead in the river.
The little flatfish?
Yeah. Oh, it's a good fish. Can you get him from right there?
I can't see him right now yet. Oops, no, not yet.
Lift up, there you go.
Yeah, there.
Holy cow. That's a fish. That's what we came for. Holy cow. Look at that thing.
Oh. Yeah, I don't believe it. That was a nice one. Couldn't get him in the net.
That's good a decent job. Fish. That's a decent fish.
Look at that, he's fin clipped.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think that was a steelhead. We haven't caught one of those in here yet, so kind of surprised.
Anybody that says you don't think little hooks can catch a big fish, look at that. So that's pretty small, but that thing just ate it. So we got a little calmer, water's nicer down here, sun's out, big fish are biting. I'm gonna go ahead and re-goop this one up a little bit here. Some Pro-Cure, this one's garlic plus. So sometimes that works, just like big fish stuff. Put that back out, see what happens here. I better pull it up. Be on there.
How deep were you? 19. Oh, he's on there. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Look at that. This thing would probably fit in your steelhead's mouth.
Nah. Probably eat better though.
Good one.
Get him out before he tangles in a net.
What'd you get that one on?
My hoochie and a smiley blade.
I'm gonna go back over that.
Make a circle.
Up. All right, we're on. Nice. Here it comes. Monster. All right. There's a few fish in the
cooler.
Tank there, yeah. So, you know, there's healthy fish here. So, I mean, nothing wrong with them.
How deep were you?
I was 20. Yeah. Just caught him one hook right in the lip. Pretty fish, though.
Mine came off. It buried that thing and off the cliff and didn't hook up.
You're still on, John?
Yeah, oh yeah, it'd be a double.
Yeah, that's a good one. Well, good way. I think probably time to end the day there. I mean, we got a lot of fish here.
Hey everybody, thanks for watching today's episode. And be sure to stop by the Angler West store in Woodland, Washington. I'm sure we can help you catch more fish. And remember, without the sponsors, there is no show. So please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.